Hey there, I made this video by the request of one of my students, John, but I thought I would just put this on YouTube for anybody who might want to learn the basic chords of Thunder Road by Bruce Springsteen. This is based off a video John sent me. It's called Bruce Springsteen, Thunder Road from In Concert / MTV Plugged. Okay. So the strumming pattern I came up with was down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. If you counted it with numbers, it would be like 1, 2, and 4, and 1. 2 and 4. What a drummer would do, like doon. So what that sounds like when you actually strum a D chord. So on beat one, like the very first down, if I'm not playing with the pick, if I'm just playing with my fingers, my thumb is actually hitting this D bass note. And I got the idea from Bruce, so thanks Bruce. So you just practice that up, down, but it's a bass note. Down, up, up, down, up. Don't forget that after the first upstroke, your hand would need to come down without touching the strings. So down, down, up, up, down, up. So it looks like my hand's moving down, and it is, but I'm not actually raking, or I'm not actually strumming. So down, down, up, down, up. That's just gonna help you keep it flowing. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. On every beat, on every count, your hand needs to move down. It's just you don't pluck the strings every time. That's kind of the foundation of guitar strumming. So down, down, so every chord will get its own bass note, and in the chord chart, I just circled in blue what the bass note would be that you would thumb pick. You can do this with the pick too. It's just really the same thing, just louder. If you're trying to play along with Bruce in this video, his tempo, his sense of time fluctuates with sort of the story and the emotion of the song. Like when his voice is getting really loud, the band is filling it up, the tempo starts getting faster. You're like, But then they bring it back down dynamically, volume wise, and the tempo slows down. So you might have a change like this, and all of a sudden it's like, you know. So when you play along, you have to just listen, really. There's a time when I was playing along with the video where it's in the bridge, that A chord at the end of the bridge. They just let it last who knows how long extra. I was just lucky that I was listening and somehow made it to the verse B, as it's called. This is like a, I don't know, an old song form. There isn't really a chorus. It's just like a song that's based around big long verses. But interspersed between all the verses is what's called a change part, which just means the chords change. So you always know you're in the change part when... Maybe you'll pick up on it from his vocals, from his melody and his singing, but that B minor chord, basically. When you hear it go from like... There is a bridge in this song, just basically another change part, but it's longer, and there is a verse B, and I call it that because it's just like this super long verse with all this extra chords at the end, that kind of ends the song. In the verses, it's more of like a quick change to D sus 4 on beat 4. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. But sometimes it looks like two times in the song he uses that D sus 4 change up as a transition or a moment of rest before another part. And in those times, so like after the second change part and after verse B before the big ending where he's playing the harmonica, he changes to D sus 4 in those times, but it's on beat 3. So it's like 1, 2, 3. So hopefully this will help you to play along with Thunder Road by Bruce Springsteen. Email me, send me an email at huddlestonsean8@gmail.com. That's the number 8. If anybody wants the charts that I have, I can just email you the photos. So thank you.